Propeller Fest in New Jersey. It's a big tech conference put together by Aaron Price, who's a phenomenal entrepreneur. I really look up to him. He's created many brands, and this is just one of them. It's a day that really brings the tech community in the Northeast together. Fun, education, and inspiration. It's a phenomenal event. It's everything from virtual reality to drones. You might see a few flying around, to startups, to VC. It's so great to finally have something here in New York where we can truly connect. They have startup competitions, Pitch Fest. It's all happening today. I have VIP tickets. I'm going to go backstage. I'm going to meet some of these phenomenal entrepreneurs and visionaries and everything from fintech to travel to beauty, you name it. The real game changers are here, and we're going to meet them firsthand. I want to give a big shout out to Jolly Beauty Bar. You always do a phenomenal job on my hair and makeup, so thank you, ladies. Also, a lot of this content today is going to be on parleyme.com. That's my private concierge service for startups. Go on, log in, sign up. You can view all the content there. This is one of those true events where you can feel the electricity in the air. Yes, it's a Friday. Yes, that makes everyone in a good mood naturally. But really, the real game changers of the tech industry are here today, and we're going to meet them one-on-one. So let's go backstage and take a look around.
My name is Aaron Price. I'm the founder of Propeller. This is a long, long, long time coming, and I want to tell you how we got here. So, I've been an entrepreneur my whole life, and every single one of those logos up there is a company that I founded or a product that I've been a part of inventing or bringing to life. My brothers here, he and I invented a weightlifting device and patented it in high school. That was my very first entree into entrepreneurship. And my best friend from college, and still today, is here. And we started one of the very first online food ordering companies, like Seamless, in 1999, when people had flip phones and the world was a whole different place. And there's all half a dozen other endeavors under there. And I've learned one thing: entrepreneurship is a rough go. And it's a very difficult career choice. You know, you might start seeing your friends have a normal career path, making a normal living. And as an entrepreneur, you're slugging away and doing your best, and sometimes you have an income and maybe sometimes you don't, but you're hustling every single day trying to bring this thing to life. And so I realized when I was working kind of on my own a lot that I needed a community of support. And I started going across the river a lot to the New York Tech Meetup and a lot of the great events that happen over there in the founder groups. And I realized, like, these are my people. And I can actually relate to these people. And I was spending a lot of time crossing the river, and I thought, you know, I bet that there are some of these people hanging out in New Jersey. I live in Hoboken, and so I started something called the New Jersey Tech Meetup. Has anybody here been to the New Jersey Tech Meetup? Solid. Well, this was a side gig. I still had my own software company, and I was just doing this once a month. The first one we did, it's, by the way, this is exactly 6 years old. It was April 10th, 2010 that we started this thing. And I thought maybe we'll get 20 people to show up and we'll talk about how we work on our businesses. How do we build a product? How do we recruit users? How do we raise capital? How do we fire people? How do we stay sane? And so the first one was 60 people. The next one was 80 people. The next one was 150 people. And they kept growing and growing and growing. And now we're the largest technology and entrepreneurship group in New Jersey. And I'd hope to say that we're a staple in sort of the regional community overall. I'll take the lame applause either way. And so I'm still, you know, hustling, trying to build this other business. And a lot of great things start coming out of this side gig, right? We start getting a lot of press from, like, the Wall Street Journal and Fast Company and BetaBeat and Inc. An entrepreneur who's here today, by the way, make sure you pitch their editors and check out their entrepreneur box that launched today. And then I get a call from the White House, which is a little more intimidating than this, but not much. And they said, we're doing the first ever tech meetup at the White House, and we'd like you to come. And not only that, we'd like you to speak, which is insane. So I went, and I talked about community and how we built the New Jersey Tech Meetup, and how when Hurricane Sandy came through here, We jumped on a crowdfunding campaign and raised 35 grand for the victims of Hurricane Sandy. How we built a tool called The Map to expose all the awesome communities of entrepreneurship that happened not just in New Jersey, but all around the region. And so, at the same time now, we're doing this for 6 years. our regions evolved. And I thought, it's time for the Northeast to have an event of our own that unifies the startup and innovation community of the whole region. There's 200 more seed stage funds than there were 6 years ago. There's 17 unicorn or billion-dollar companies. There's a whole suite of co-working spaces, one that we opened here in Hoboken called Mission 50, the Alley, one of our great partners here today, across the river. The area is booming with technology and innovation and entrepreneurship. And I said, it's time to do something that brings us all together. We don't have to keep flying to Austin. And so, welcome to Propeller. Now, the most amazing thing about this is I've only been, we're gonna get better on the claps as this day goes on, I promise. It's still early. They're pissed about us for waiting on that line, it's okay. So, I've only had software products, right? You guys are now walking through our product. I still see this as our beta launch. You're our users. There are partners and our sponsors and the press is here. This is our traction, the physical representation of the product that we've been working so hard to bring to life over the last 6 months and for me really over the last 10 years. And so when this happened, I thought, well, I don't really have a lot of resources. I'm gonna need some help. And so I reached out to my New Jersey Tech Meetup group, approaching 6,000 members, and I said, hey guys, who wants to volunteer to build what we think is going to become the biggest innovation community event in the Northeast? And I've worked with volunteers before, and if you've ever done that, they can be a little flaky. You got to really get stuff done, or you're fired from your volunteer position. So I thought maybe that way I'd get like 5 or 6 or 7 good people. 119 people filled out that form. This is where the lame clapping has to stop. These guys need a massive round of applause. For the last 4 months, we've been getting together weekly. We've got team captains. Everything, every single thing you see here today is a result of their enormous, enormous effort. It was really hard to just pick one photo. I can't possibly try to name all these people who've helped out. There are an enormous number of people who've dedicated so much time, so many resources. They're not the only people who helped make this happen, though. You know, Brad Feld likes to talk about entrepreneurs having a silent partner. Entrepreneurship, I talked about, it's a rough career choice. It could be a very difficult thing to do. It could be hard on your relationships. It could be hard on your home front. And if you don't have support from home, you got nothing to go on. And so it's really important to me that we take a minute to also thank my wife, who stood by me of 10 years. Guys, with the applause here, you gotta bring it big time. Rebecca, thank you. I love you. I could not have done this without you. So it also turns out we needed money, right? You may notice there's a lot of stuff here. This stuff costs a lot of money. And so we started making phone calls to places like Stevens, who wrote the very first check, and introduced us to Nokia Bell Labs, who wrote the very next check. And things started to really come together. And I can't tell you enough how much I enormously appreciate every single one of these exhibitors and sponsors who have made this happen. This is not a small undertaking. This is not an inexpensive undertaking. And I'm not just up here saying, oh yeah, hey, thanks to our sponsors, this was cool. I am saying I am indebted to you. I appreciate everything that you've done. Thank you for believing in us and helping us make today a reality. One more last not lame of applause for these guys for making this happen. So we launched Propeller. Now this brand, I've built a lot of brands. This thing means a lot to me. It's got a cool logo and it sounds kind of cool, but I want to tell you what this is all about. In running the New Jersey Tech Meetup, I got a lot of people coming up to me going, hey man, Instagram was my idea. I got this great idea. And there are probably a million great ideas on this lawn here today. But there's only one thing between that idea and success, and that's your own ability to propel that thing forward. Whether it's propelling yourself out of bed, your business forward, your team forward. Think about this beautiful piece of machinery that's an airplane as your idea. If you don't have that forward motion, it drops out of the sky. And that's the only thing that makes any of these companies that you see here today, some of the most innovative companies, not just in the region, but in the country, that's what makes this work. And so what we like to say is idle ideas don't fly. If you're sitting there today thinking you've got an idea, that's great. The only thing that matters is if you bring it to life. And today, that's what this is all about. It's time to get started. Let's propel. So, there are three key tenets to what makes this thing hum. Inspiration, education, and fun. If these three things do not happen for you today, you get your money back. Do you have fun? Because what's the point of all this if you can't do that?